the Otto cycle engine naturally inherits secondary vibration in its design, yeah. So we'll be looking into this. This will be a simple explanation more on visual and design of this secondary vibration rather than all the mathematical formulas, yeah. So from a design perspective itself, the secondary vibration is quite apparent, yeah. Basically, it's inconsistent speed of the piston stroke relative to the crankshaft stroke, yeah. On one part of the crankshaft throw, the piston is traveling slower, and on the other part of the crankshaft throw, the piston is traveling faster. So when the piston is going faster than the crankshaft balance, as it hits stop dead center and leaves it will cause a small vibration as the ballast won't be heavy enough to counter the G forces of the piston. And as the piston slows down towards bottom dead center and leaves bottom dead center, the piston's G force won't be enough to counter the speed of the crankshaft ballast, and the ballast will cause another secondary vibration. Yeah, even though when the piston goes down, it will create a vibration going up, and when the piston goes up again, it will cause another vibration going upwards. The crankshaft is not just going up, but its crank pin is also moving away from the piston center line. As it moves away, it is pulling the piston down. However, the crank pin is still going up at a greater rate. Put these two together, and a piston goes up slower than the crank pin. Here is an example. Say there is a car, and when it is pulled at an angle, it will move backwards. So this is the effect that's happening to the crank and piston. Let's leave the crank at this angle after bottom dead center. Now let's move the connecting rod towards the middle. Notice the piston moving upwards in recovery. What would happen is the crank pin is moving again at a greater rate. Then it is moving away from the piston center line. And if you combine these together, it will slow down the piston's rate at going up relative to the crank pin going up. Now let's see what happens when the crank angle moves towards the top dead center. The crank is now straightening the connecting rod. The reverse effect is now taking place. It is pushing the piston towards its center line. This accelerates the piston on top of the rate that the crank pin is going. This combination makes the piston move towards the top dead center faster than the crank pin. Mirror effect happens as the piston moves away from top dead center on the way downwards. This time the piston is going downwards. The crank now is pulling the piston away from its center line. On top of this is the crank pin moving downwards. This accelerates the piston downwards to the halfway mark where the piston starts to slow down. Here the piston starts to slow down as the crankshaft begins to move the connecting rod towards the piston center line, and this has the effect of moving the piston upwards but at a much lesser rate than the crank pin moving downwards. Combine this again and the piston is moving slower towards the top dead center. Interestingly, with an extended connecting rod, also known as a long rod, it reduces its angle at the crankshaft halfway mark, and this also reduces the difference in piston crank pin travel, thus also reducing the difference in velocity that would amount to a reduction in secondary vibration.